Hello friends, let's start a new lecture of photochemistry, and in this lecture we are going to see some more examples, some more rearrangement, that is of dipyrimethane rearrangement. So they are azo dipyrimethane rearrangement and oxo dipyrimethane rearrangement. So let's see one by one. First is azo dipyrimethane rearrangement. See, there is no any change, means drastic change in azo dipyrimethane rearrangement or oxo dipyrimethane rearrangement. Simply, azo means there is a nitrogen atom present in the 1,4-diene system, and in case of oxo dipyrimethane rearrangement, there is oxygen present at the means in 1,4-diene system. So see, in case of azo 1-dipyrimethane rearrangement, there is a nitrogen atom present, where it may be at first position or at the second position of 1,4-diene system. So in case of azo dipyrimethane rearrangement, photochemical reaction of 1-azo-1,4-diene or 2-azo-1,4-diene in a triplet excited state to form the corresponding cyclopropyl amines. So see, the compound may be 1-azo-1,4-diene. 1-azo means at one position there is a nitrogen atom, 1-azo-1,4-diene, 1 and at four position diene system, and third carbon is sp3 hybridized carbon. So it may be 1-azo-1,4-diene or 2-azo-1,4-diene, means at two position there will be a nitrogen atom. So 2-azo-1,4-diene, after rearrangement it will gives you cyclopropylamine and corresponding aziridine products. So let's see one by one. In case of 1-azo-1,4-diene, here you can see 1-azo-1,4-diene after triplet state sensitized molecule or in presence of electron donor or electron acceptor sensitizer molecule, you will get a simply product, that is after rearrangement you will get simply cyclopropyl amines. But in case of a 2-azo-1,4-diene triplet sensitizer, if you use, then you will get a simply same product, cyclopropyl amines and cyclopropyl imines. Imine means at nitrogen atom there is a double bond, so it is imine, cyclopropyl and imine. So cyclopropyl imines. And if we are using, in case of a 2-azo-1,4-diene, if you are using electron acceptor sensitized molecule, then you will get a different product, that is N-vinyl aziridines. N-vinyl aziridines means nitrogen containing a vinyl group. So N-vinyl aziridine. Okay, let's see its mechanism. Okay, simply in case of 1-azo-1,4-diene, you will get same compound as like a dipyrimethane rearrangement. So in presence of sensitizer, there is a first aplegica mechanism hota. But dipyrimethane rearrangement madhe same tasas rahnar hai. First is a formation of radical, so just do homolytic fission of this both bonds, there will be a breaking of this bond, you will get two radicals, and breaking of this bond you will get successive two radicals. So these two radicals, as like the dipyrimethane rearrangement, you have to add this second and fourth position radical, and new bond formation takes place here. So let's do that. Okay, now in the second step is breaking of bond, any bond from this position, this bond or this bond, because these two are old radicals, this is newly formed radical. Now you have to break one of these two bonds, this one or this one. Now see, nitrogen is unstable, so you have to stabilize it. So breaking of this bond is preferable. The bond at side of nitrogen, you have to break this bond. So it homolytic fission gives two radical formation like this. So these two radicals, here one and here one. So this radical will make a new bond with nitrogen, and this will remain a free radical. See, okay, this is newly formed double bond, and now as like dipyrimethane rearrangement, these two radicals will make a new bond to get a cyclopropane ring. Okay, so this is your cyclopropyl imine. Final structure of 1-azo-1,4-diene, that is 1-azo-1,4-diene, finally you will get cyclopropyl imines. Cyclopropyl compound is there, and imine, nitrogen containing a double bond, so it is cyclopropyl imine compound. Now see, when there is a nitrogen present at two position, this reaction is simply as dipyrimethane rearrangement. Okay, when the compound containing a nitrogen at two position, same type of reaction will take place. See, first formation of radical, then these two radicals, second and fourth position radical will make a new bond, right? But now the condition is different. Which bond will be break first? See, A bond can be breakdown and B bond breakdown will take place. Let's see one by one what will be the product. If A breakdown of A takes place, then this bond will break down. This bond is broken down, then you will get nitrogen radical and this carbon radical. So after this, nitrogen and this carbon radical will make a bond. So you will get a double bonded nitrogen. And finally, these two radicals will make a new bond. After getting this combination of these two radicals, we will get a cyclopropane ring, right? So this is your structure. It's simply like a back structure, but now the nitrogen at second position, right? So it is a cyclopropyl amine also. Okay, now if we do the breaking of the second bond, that is B bond, then you will get two radicals. One will be here and one will be here. Let's see. Okay, now see, again there is the formation of double bond. Here will be the formation of double bond. So we'll get double bond. And finally, these two radicals. This radical, just flip this bond here. So there's two radicals, this radical and this radical, remaining radical will make a bond and you will get N vinyl aziridine. So nitrogen containing vinyl group. So just N vinyl aziridine. So the main point that if there is a 1-azo-1,4-diene or 2-azo-1,4-diene in presence of sensitizer, 1-azo-1,4-diene you will get a cyclopropylamine. So there will be nitrogen at first position. And in case of 2-azo-1,4-diene, you will get two products, that is cyclopropylamine and N-vinyl aziridine. Okay. This is of 2-azo-dipymethane rearrangement. Let's see about oxo-dipymethane rearrangement. So in case of oxo-dipymethane rearrangement, only there is a change that we are using carbonyl compound. So there will be an oxygen present in a dipymethane rearrangement. So this is one example of oxo-dipymethane rearrangement. As for the, you have to do same procedure like a dipymethane rearrangement. First there is a formation of radical, then bond formation between two radicals, then breaking of bond by looking the stability of maybe intermediate or maybe product. Okay, see, the first will be then after photochemical reaction, first reaction is photolysis of bond, that is radical formation. After radical formation, you have to do addition of this two, that is radical at second position and fourth position. Then simply new bond formation takes place. Now see, as per the nitrogen radical, this oxygen radical is highly unstable. So you have to stabilize this oxygen radical, and because of that, you have to break this bond, the bond at side of oxygen. You have to break this bond. So you will be getting this carbon radical and this carbon radical. So the next compound is like this. Okay. So now afterward, this newly formed radical and this oxygen radical will make a bond. And this whole chain will shift it here. Just see. Okay. This newly formed bond. So oxygen is now stabilized. And here we have a new radical and this radical will make a bond. So again we getting a cyclopropane ring. Okay, in case of a dipymethane rearrangement, so you are getting at final structure cyclopropane ring and double bond. In azo-dipymethane rearrangement also, double bond and cyclopropane ring. And in oxo-dipymethane rearrangement also, cyclopropane ring and double bond. So cyclopropane ring is a must. If there is a azo, then you will get imines. If there is a simply alkenes, then you will get alkenes. And in case of oxo, you are getting a carbonyl group. Okay. See one more example of oxo-dipymethane rearrangement. Looking somewhat complicated, but just by looking the compound, you are getting the idea that if there is a double bond is present at 1 and 4th position, or the third carbon is sp3 hybridized or not. Okay. So see, if you are, we have this structure, that is 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, so 1 and 4 position having a double bond, and 1, 2, and 3. So our third carbon is also sp3 hybridized. So yes, there is the oxo-dipymethane rearrangement is possible in this compound. Let's do it now. जस्ट आफ्टर फोटोकेमिकल रिएक्शन यू हैव टू ब्रेक बॉन्ड्स, दिस कार्बोनिल विल गेट कार्बन रेडिकल एंड ऑक्सीजन रेडिकल एंड दिस विल आफ्टर होमोलाइटिक फिशन गिव्स यू टू रेडिकल्स. लेट्स डू ओके एज पर दिस. नाउ द सेकेंड इज सेम, दैट इज यू हैव टू एड सेकेंड एंड फोर्थ नंबर कार्बन रेडिकल्स, सो यू विल मेक अ न्यू बॉन्ड हियर. ओके दिस इज न्यूली फॉर्म बॉन्ड. नाउ यू हैव टू ब्रेक आउट ऑफ दिस टू बॉन्ड्स, सो विच विल बी ब्रोकन डाउन, दिस वन, द बॉन्ड नियर टू द ऑक्सीजन. यू हैव टू ब्रेक दिस, जस्ट ब्रेक इट, यू विल गेट अ टू रेडिकल्स. दिस टू रेडिकल्स हियर विल बी वन रेडिकल एंड हियर विल बी वन रेडिकल. नाउ इन नेक्स्ट स्टेप दिस टू रेडिकल विल मेक अ न्यू बॉन्ड एंड कार्बोनिल कंपाउंड, मीन्स कार्बोनिल ऑक्सीजन एंड कार्बन डबल बॉन्ड रीजनरेट्स. नाउ द रिमेनिंग रेडिकल हियर वन इज रिमेनिंग रेडिकल, सो दिस रेडिकल एंड दिस रेडिकल विल मेक अ न्यू बॉन्ड, सो विल गेट अ साइक्लोप्रोपेन रिंग. सॉरी दिस. सो नाउ इन दिस यूर स्ट्रक्चर यू हैव अ डबल बॉन्ड, न्यूली फॉर्म डबल बॉन्ड एंड साइक्लोप्रोपेन रिंग ऑल्सो. जस्ट आई रीअरेंज दिस कंपाउंड इन सिंपली मैनर. सी टू साइक्लोपेंटेन रिंग्स हियर, टू साइक्लोपेंटेन रिंग्स, वन टू थ्री फोर फाइव दिस वन एंड वन टू थ्री फोर फाइव दिस. दिस टू साइक्लोप्रोपेन रिंग्स कनेक्टेड विद अ सेम बॉन्ड. ओके सो टू साइक्लोप्रोपेन रिंग्स कनेक्टेड विद द सेम बॉन्ड एंड हैविंग अ वन साइक्लो सॉरी साइक्लोपेंटेन रिंग, साइक्लोपेंटेन रिंग कनेक्टेड विद अ सिंपल सेम बॉन्ड एंड वन साइक्लोप्रोपेन रिंग इन बिटवीन देम, वन साइक्लोप्रोपेन रिंग इन बिटवीन देम कनेक्टेड विद अ टू बॉन्ड्स राइट. सो एंड एट सेकेंड पोजिशन देर इज ऑक्सीजन कार्बोनिल कंपाउंड, एट सेकेंड पोजिशन देर इज अ कार्बोनिल ग्रुप. ओके सो दिस इज सिंपल मैनर. दिस इज ऑल अबाउट ऑक्सा डाइपाइमिथेन रीअरेंजमेंट. सिंपली इन केस ऑफ अजा डाइपाइमिथेन रीअरेंजमेंट एंड ऑक्सा डाइपाइमिथेन रीअरेंजमेंट द मैकेनिज्म इज रिमेन सेम. यू हैव टू फर्स्ट ब्रेक डाउन ऑफ दिस टू बॉन्ड्स, दैट इज वन एंड फोर्थ पोजिशन डबल बॉन्ड एंड देन यू हैव टू डू जस्ट एडिशन ऑफ टू एंड फोर्थ पोजिशन रेडिकल. देन यू हैव टू ब्रेक द एनी वन ओल्ड बॉन्ड. ओके which will make a stabilized intermediate or stabilized product. Then just simply as per these three reactions are same, means simpler dipyrimethane rearrangement, azadipyrimethane rearrangement and oxadipyrimethane rearrangement. In azadipyrimethane rearrangement there is only difference that there is nitrogen atom present at one and two position, one or two position, and in case of oxadipyrimethane rearrangement there is a presence of carbonyl compound only. Okay. This is enough for this lecture. Thank you.